They left him at his desk, staring at the wank. Alabama took to the stage at Debussy. Sunday night, the half-filled room held hardcore party people, those who worked alternative hours, and hospos. A jazz trio backed up Alabama, whose musical style was a mashup of Cocteau Twins and Kate Bush. She wore her mum's wedding dress, no other choice under this week's circumstances, a floor-length crushed velvet backless number in rusted tangerine. Straight out of the 70s it was, like all of Agnes's marriages. She had reminisced tonight as she helped Alabama do her platinum locks in a flick-out and apply sky-blue eyeshadow with tangerine lipstick. It was in a field. We were all on mushrooms. Most were naked. I wore the dress as a rebellion, really. Everyone was so into their nudity, but I was over it by then. And the guy you married? Betty had asked, hoping some light might be shed on Alabama's father. It drove Alabama nuts that her mum never shared any details about his identity. He went naked, just wore the cuffs and collar, cut off a white shirt and a pink tie. Like Snagglepuss, kept saying, "Exit, stage right, stage fright," and laughing his head off. Mind you, it wasn't a legal ceremony. We didn't dig that stuff.
Romantic,
Alabama threw in.
He was. Very,
Agnes said, leaning against the doorway as if the weight of memory had pinned her there. Nothing further could be gleaned as to Alabama's dad's identity. So, Betty had walked to Debussy after her shift at Carcassonne.